Hello guys, welcome to the Let's Play of Hearts of Iron 4, my first Let's Play regarding Hearts of Iron series. I've just tested the game, to be honest, never really played a full game of Hearts of Iron 4. The one I most played from the series was 2. I somewhat never got into 3, and I don't know, I wouldn't say it's fair towards the Hearts of Iron 3rd game in the series. Just had no time and was distracted by some other things, but I really plan to get into Hearts of Iron 4. So basically this should be somewhat of a playthrough and a tutorial at the same time. Now I've gone through the nations already, and let's just select the scenario. I always like going for the earliest option. It gives you enough time, you know, to go for the technology tree you wish and develop in a direction you wish, whomever you take. So I'm gonna start with the 1st of January 1936. Anyways, I've gone through the countries now. As much as interesting it is to play with one of the major forces, I somewhat always like to pick some of the other countries. And this time I'm gonna go for Yugoslavia. Now, no any particular reason for that. It's just through the history, actually, regarding the Second World War, what Yugoslavs tried was to play a game between the East and the West and stay neutral as much as possible. Unfortunately, it didn't go for them that well. At some point, they were attacked by Germans. So I'm going to try and recreate that piece of history, try and stay neutral as much as possible, but on the other hand, maybe, depending on how the game goes, maybe even join the German Reich and try to stop Russians and US from seizing back the German soil. We'll see how it goes. Well, that's all the fun, you know. Paradox Games give you an option to recreate history in a weird manner. Now, as this is supposed to be a Let's Play and a learning lesson, so to say, at once, I'm gonna go for the recruit difficulty. Now, before you guys start swearing and, you know, saying bad things about how it's too easy or this or that, once again, it's supposed to be like a lesson of Hearts of Iron 4. I'm also going to get into it as my first game, and therefore I'm gonna set the difficulty to recruit just to get into the mechanics. I've seen something briefly, but as said already, I've never finished a single game. Only it actually started one and just played it really, really shortly. So, let's just see what does the Iron Mode give. Iron Mode, console cheats are disabled and the game is automatically saved regularly to a single file. In games played with this setting, there is no turning back. Okay, we can do that. Anyways, we are not going to load. Historical AI focuses. Wonder if I should be tempering with that at the moment. Ah, let's leave it. Let's leave it for the first game. So, Yugoslavia it is. Prince Paul is the leader, non-aligned at the moment. Authoritarian regime. Yep. That's weird. Actually, it's not weird. It complies with what they were doing historically, but... Alright, Resisting Council. Yeah. Okay, let's see. Yeah, I can do it. So, as said already, it's gonna be those of you who still haven't got into it to get into the game mechanics and so on and so on, and we'll see where does this game of playing as Yugoslavia take us. So, 19 divisions at the moment, I suppose. Yeah, the navy now is not that great as well. My guess the same for Air Force. Exactly. So the first things first, before any conflict and any war, I'm gonna set the speed to high just to avoid too much time being wasted, because one thing clear, we're gonna have a lot of, so to say, gaps in this playthrough, as we'll have a lot of stagnant periods where we'll be just building and studying things and not doing anything and be waiting for our own 5 minutes of glory. So research slots available. Alright, we've got three research slots at the beginning. So where do we start with? Let's see. Yeah, 18 factories in total. All right, so the best thing is to focus on industry for the beginning. So we'll go, yeah, construction speed plus 10%, definitely that's gonna be the pick of the day. Production efficiency cap, yeah, fair enough as well. And let's see, where do we go with the third one? Such time, infantry. All right, we can go for the armor. I doubt really I'm gonna make my navy and air force too strong. The thing is, when you pick one of the countries that are not major powers in any Hearts of Iron, you barely get the chance to concentrate on all the fields equally. When I say concentrate on all the fields equally, I mean you barely get the chance to, you know, expand both or all of the forces, the air force, the naval force and the ground forces, in the same manner. So you gotta focus on one, and to be fair enough, yeah, we're gonna focus on infantry and armor. Maybe, just maybe, one day if things play in our own direction, and as we imagined, we might extend the focus to air force as well, but definitely not the naval base. Especially if we align with Germany and the Italians, at least for the moment our shores will be free. The Italians should more or less be controlling all the sea around Yugoslavia, so yeah. Anyway, free civilian factories. Now, the way factories function, you've got a certain number of factories for military, naval dockyards and civilian factories. The military factories, you can see that each of the things we are producing at the moment have one factory assigned. That's a total of three. We've got, for example, you can remove the, or you know, if you want to remove, yeah, the, something from production line, you'll do it this way by clicking the cancel. But at some point you'll see, when we get to have more than three military factories, you'll be able to, you know, assign them. Like, for example, if we got five at the moment, you'll be able to add, I don't know, another two here, and therefore the support equipment will be made faster. But as we have only three at the moment, we can only build three different things. So yeah, we're definitely gonna have to build military factories. Civilian factories, on the other hand, you're using them to trade, which might be a bit awkward, I don't know, but you're using them to trade for goods you'll need for the production queue. For example, you can see that even at the very beginning of the game, we are missing steel, we are missing oil as well. So each of the things you'll be building require a certain amount of different resources, and you'll be using your free civilian factories to trade for those resources you are missing. Let's see. Therefore, the civilian factories are important as well. So, okay, let's start. I'm gonna start with a few civilian factories by clicking on it. You'll choose the region where you wanna build it. The left number shows how many you've built, the right number shows the maximum number of this type of factories you've chosen in the certain area. So, I don't know, let's go and build another one in Bosnia. Now, eight factories are used to build another civilian factory, so it's gonna, wow, 225 days, dear god, it's a great wonder we are building. Okay, we'll leave it be. We've got three dockyards as well. Dockyards are used for the production of the naval forces, so yeah, picking one, for example, let's say we'll be using one naval dockyard to produce. Anyways, we're gonna leave this be at the moment as it is. We're not gonna trade for steel nor oil for the moment, because I want my civilian factories to be used. Yeah, because if you trade with the civilian factories, this number on the left is gonna be reducing, and the less factories you have that are being used for building a certain thing, the slower it's gonna happen. So even with the eight factories used for building, we need 225 days. So if I use another few civilian factories to trade in order to get the oil and steel we're missing, this number here is gonna even reduce to 6 or 5. Therefore, I suppose this is gonna reach an amount of 1 year. So until we build a few civilian factories and get another few through the techs we're gonna be studying, sorry, I'm not gonna touch that. Okay, no national focus set. Definitely go for the industry. It's a nice, definitely nicely looking tree and a different from what I'm used to, or you guys as well. Let's see, industrial effort. One time 50% research bonus for industry, definitely. Let's go for that. Low manpower. Yeah, I know, but we are not in the war with anyone. The insufficient resources tab that's occasionally gonna pop out here. By clicking on it, you can see that it will be swapping towards the resources you're missing. So it's pointing to us, we are missing steel and we are missing oil, but we know that already from the production queue. We know we are missing that, so we're just gonna play dead on that one for the moment. And yeah, let's unpause and start. So total of 19 divisions, even a few cavalry divisions we've got. All right, let it be. So anyways, still haven't decided if you're really to be staying in the middle between the Germans or the Axis and Allies, or should we align with one at some point. We'll see how the game goes. For sure our first territorial enemies, or so to say, would be Albania and Bulgaria. So we'll see as the game progresses, in case we manage to hop onto Albania before the Italians take it. We'll do it, definitely. As Yugoslavia, you cannot declare war before the world tension is 50%. In order to do that, in Hearts of Iron 4, you'll first have to justify war goal, which you cannot do as well before the world tension reaches 50%. So until then, not much we can do. The political power that is changing will be using to either improve relations with different countries, or you'll see already how it functions. Also will okay, you'll see already how it's being used on the best manner. So get used to plenty of this type of gaps in the game itself. There's nothing much we can do at the moment, I suppose, if you take Germans or Russians or USA or Italy or one of the major powers anyway. You'll be having plenty to do at the beginning of the game, but we're just gonna focus on industry and try and renew the industry of the fallen Yugoslavia until the wartime, or at least let's say 1938, 1939. We'll see how the game progresses anyway, and whether we can stay alive when the game ends. I'm not sure when that happens here, haven't checked it. Maybe, I don't know, 1946 or something, but we'll see how it goes. Alright, as in every game, I suppose the first war, so to say, is gonna happen. Remilitarization happened, alright. I'm just waiting for the Republicans and Nationalists in Spain to start fighting. That should happen quite soon. Okay. Construction okay, this is nice. Construction effort adds one building slots and adds one civilian factory to the existing. So we'll have 18 at that point. Yeah, definitely want to go for that at the moment. Okay. Yugoslavia is in a good position to say, though you've got the Italians and the Germans at your doors, or so to say, especially after the Germans Anschluss Austria. They are in a somewhat good position, and we'll see to utilize that more and more as I'm looking at the map and thinking, you know, a few years ahead, more. It comes to my mind that we should be aligning with the Germans and potentially try and stop Russians from a counterattack that's inevitably gonna come at some point. But again, we'll see how the game progresses. Our only aim here is survive. So the 1% world tension has been generated by the Germans. Yeah, we'll be waiting for that to grow slowly. see how the techs progress. Heavy tank soon to come. Okay, so once you generate 150 of political power, you'll get this type of message saying modify government. Now you can be choosing different laws. You've got this stack here connected to research and production, and you've got military staff stack where you can be changing people in command. So for the moment, let's see, political advisors, national unity, civilian factory. Oh, definitely. Yeah, okay. Ivan Ribar, we found our man. The first guy we're gonna choose. That's nice. We wanna speed up as much as possible those civilian factories or civilian factory build. Okay, so we now have 17. Should get one more. After studying construction, I'll get the bonus for construction speed as well. And after finishing the national focus on construction effort, we'll get another civilian factory. So, yeah, going there slowly. Okay, the good thing is that the Bulgarian capital is just across the border, so whenever we step into fighting with them, shouldn't take them long before they fall and give up. Alright. Yeah, Albania doesn't even have an army. Okay, basic machine tools. Let's see. Efficiency cap, that's nice. Improved machine tools, gonna give us another production efficiency cap. Factory output, maximum factory so instead plus 20%. Okay, we're gonna go for dispersed industry. Working on an industry, left, right, and center, that's what we need. National focus completed, construction efforts. So we got our free civilian factory. I'm gonna go for another. Also, yeah, you can see we've got 11 out of 15 building now. And here's the 12th to come soon. Then days remaining. Okay. This represents the total number of factories you've got, so yeah, I suppose the naval dockyard's gonna remain the least used throughout the whole game. Okay, it's gonna pop out every time, free civilian factories, every time you finish building either the civilian factory or military factory. So as we finished, let's see if this number now reduced from 225 days it needed. Let's see, what does it need now? 134, alright. That's better, that's much better. So we'll go for another. I still don't want to trade the civilian factories for the resources, though I'm gonna do it quite soon. But not yet. Okay, construction efforts, another 40 days. Yeah, we definitely need civilian factories. Okay, I'm gonna leave the units at the moment. Leave them be. There's a nice little thing I've seen here. Oh, rocket sights. Reactor. That's nice. Anyways, I was gonna say, yeah, I think this is it. Yeah, convert civilian factories to military factory and vice versa. So. That's nice. You in, you know, periods of war, you can convert your civilian factories to military factories, and I'm not sure if you can do it once you do that, if you can return them back. Reading from this, you should be able, but you never know. At some point we'll also probably see how that functions. Anyways, we've got heavy tanks, or at least the very first of the heavy tanks. I'm gonna start improving the light tanks, or let me see, maybe we can wait. Let's see, support battalions, support weapons one, alright, let's do that, get another free. Industry, construction speed. Yeah, let's go for it. 1937 technology, but we're not that far from it, so yeah, we should be going for it. Yugoslavia, right, construction going on well for the moment. The production screen is still poor, but we've got just 3 military factories, so yeah. We'll also go through how the upgrade system works in this episode of Hearts of Iron. We'll see that at some point once we get to infantry equipment 2 in our tech 3 or to light tanks 2. Anyways, at the moment we've studied the heavy tanks as well. So in order to produce the heavy tanks, we'll need to add them here. But we just don't have a free military factory to cover it at the moment. But anyways, we'd be adding it here, and after that, in the recruit and deployment screen, we'll be either creating a new division or editing the existing one, like the tank divisions we've got. We can edit it and add heavy tanks. Now, you'll see that it's gonna ask for army experience points, in case you didn't notice. Army experience points are here. Now we've got 0 at the moment. You either get to those, there are multiple ways to get army experience points. The most obvious one is through fighting. Whether you are fighting with the ground infantry, you'll be getting army experience points here. In case you're using navy to fight or using it in a battle, your navy experience is going to be growing, and I think by now it's quite clear how your air experience is going to be growing. Also, this is a number of convoys. I'll show you that at some point as well, what they are used for trading, and I'll show you how, for example, if I wanna trade for the oil we are missing. And you can see the amount United States have ready for exporting. In case I try to trade with them, clicking this button is gonna set the amount that you need. So you can't like buy 6. It's gonna go 8 or 0. Or 0, 8, the next step will be 6 and so on and so on. But anyways, the important thing is you can see that we have 10 free convoys and it requires 7 for this trade, because USA is far from Yugoslavia. It will require 7 trade convoys to reach them and exchange the goods. Therefore, we'll be always going for the closest countries, unless, you know, politics or war do not allow you that. So in this case, for example, if you want to trade oil with Romania, which is your neighbor, you'll see that only one convoy will be used for the trade instead of, 7 convoys, yeah, for United States. Anyways, meanwhile, we got our 150 points again, so let's see where we can use it. Industrial concern, industrial research time minus 10%. Yeah, this is one of the ways you can also get your military experience. Plus 0.05 daily. The third way, except for war and one of the guys that will lead in your country, or be taking part in your government, that can also influence the growth of army experience points. The third way, sorry, just a second. I'm just gonna cross-check. What can we do with this 150 points of national power we've got? Do we go immediately for army experience? Yeah, we'll go immediately. Because we cannot edit or create our divisions without the military points or army experience points. Anyways, the third way would be organizing an army, assigning a certain commander. Once that is done, which I do not want to do at the moment because it also wastes equipment, once that is done, you'll have a small tab here saying train or something like that. You'll be actually telling your general to train those divisions, and they'll be getting or providing or accumulating, call it whichever way you want, they'll be accumulating army experience for you. But for the moment, I think it's just more than enough. Okay, Ethiopia was annexed. For the moment, it's just more than enough that we, you know, pick this guy to be building an army experience. Since you don't need like thousands of points, 15 or 10 or 15 will be just more than enough to shape the division the way you want it for the moment. Okay, let's see. Construction effort 2. Okay, we could add a few military factories now as well. We are still building a civilian factory. Concentrated industry, well done. Okay, factory output, production efficiency cap. Yeah, or we could start reducing the research time slowly. 2% is nothing much, but 2 by 2, we're gonna reach somewhere. Okay, let's see. Sorry for that. And the game's concluded. Hey, Jesse Owens. Alright, we'll still continue building. Okay, as soon as we get enough points to add tanks to our divisions, or to add heavy tanks to our divisions, we're gonna do so. Just need to build the industry. We need to focus on industry for the war time, because once the war comes, we need to be ready to be able to produce divisions, and to produce good divisions. It's not always about the number of divisions, but about the equipment they've got. So at some point in the future, we're gonna be adding artillery as a support, anti-tanks, anti-aircrafts, field hospitals, and so on and so on. But you'll see that already. Don't want to talk ahead. This is probably the most boring part of the game, the first few years, especially when playing as a minor nation. Okay. We do not want an army for the moment, we just used it for an example. Meanwhile, let's check the resources in the neighborhood, see where we stand with it. Yeah, we definitely have aluminium, a lot of it at our disposal, but steel is the biggest problem. Here, yeah, but look at the oil. That's why Hitler pinpointed Romanian fields of oil. Dear God. Not counting Russia, I don't know if there's that much oil anywhere in Europe. All right. Back to building. RT3 civilian factories, that means we've just built the previous. And no matter how mad it sounds, let's go for another one. Okay, we got ourselves another military factory. So it's gonna show us for the first time that we've got a free military factory. That means we've got a total of 4 and we are currently using 3. One for each of those. So we are free to add another one. I'm gonna go for infantry equipment as we still need another 9,000 weapons for the army. And let's see, is it the time? Is it the right time to... Yeah, after this one is built, we're gonna start... definitely we're going to start trading for the resources. Currently have 14 out of 15 working on this one. This one's gonna be a 15th. So that's gonna be just about time to start building military factories and start trading for the resources we do not have. Meanwhile, our army experience is gathering. What we could start doing is also improving relations with our nasty neighbors, which is Italy. It costs 10 points. Yeah. We're gonna start improving them. As you can see at the moment, we are at minus with Italy, but it's starting to improve. Yeah, they're gonna turn positive with Germans soon. Anyway, that's German opinion of Yugoslavia, and the one up is our own opinion of the other country we're looking at. So, alright. We're gonna be using that, or we're gonna be using that quite often, because we wanna stay in good relations with them as much as possible and avoid being one of the first targeted countries. Okay, so we finished this. Let's see if we can further reduce the research time. 20 days. Yeah, let's go for it. And soon we'll have enough political power. We'll have the 150 we wish. Support weapons 1. Okay. Improved infantry equipment. Okay, go for it. That is gonna take almost a year, but nevertheless we want it. Okay, another 25 days before we get another military factory. We're just gonna continue down this row now for a few techs, get a few military factories. This modify our comments. Let's see. Fascism on the rise, communist on the rise, move towards democracy. Industrial research time. Okay. Move towards industry still. Nice for the moment. Looking fine. I managed to do some quite odd things in Hearts of Iron 2, like Yugoslavia going all the way to Iraq. You wouldn't believe it. It was literally looking like this with Greece and all of the Turkey being Yugoslavia. I'll just see one big Yugoslavia written all over this place. I doubt even at the easiest level it's possible here, because the game is much more realistic and much more tougher. But we'll see what funny and odd history can we create. Anyways, we'll go for... Yeah, we'll continue down this tree. Continue piling up military factories. We just got one. So we now stand at 5. 4 being used. Let's see, how much would it cost us to edit the tank divisions and add a heavy tank? If we add it and we save it... Okay, it's gonna take 5. Yeah, go for it. Go for it, we'll save it. It's gonna tell us we are missing equipment production, so I'll explain that immediately. We're gonna start training tank divisions. We'll choose a location where it's gonna be deployed, let's say somewhere in Serbia. Now, the reason it's saying we are missing equipment production is because we are not producing the heavy tanks. We've got them assigned to a tank division, but we are not producing them, so in order for them to start being trained and appear there, we're gonna choose them from here. And we just got our one factory that was not used transferred to 80 to sorry heavy tank production. So I'm gonna start gathering the resources we are missing now. So it's basically steel and oil we are missing, so we're gonna trade for oil. Definitely Romania will be our choice, as they are quite near. And steel, start trading with Germans. Okay, so you can now see that none of the things we are producing misses resources. They all have their resources set. You can also see that from the trade screen. You'll see the resources up here, and you'll see the surplus amount. In case you, the resource you're looking at is not surplus, you'll be having a minus written here. So at the moment we are either at ground zero or in a surplus achievement of the certain resource. So yeah, doing fine. We finally got ourselves a tank division being trained. So if you put your mouse or hover your mouse here, it's gonna tell you it needs 54 more light tanks, and it needs a lot of infantry equipment and heavy tanks to be built before it can spit out a division. You can set a priority. Currently all these things are standing at middle. You can set a priority. No current upgrade requests. So let's see. Okay. Yeah, we've set a high priority for the tank divisions being built. So at the moment they look like this, really poorly. One light tank, a few infantry, yeah, battalions inside. We've got a heavy tank. But we're gonna be adding more support quite soon. For the moment, this is the best we can do with the little five military factories we've got. So this tempo of 1.5 per month will need like 60 months to produce all the tanks we need, which is like 5 years almost, so we are not going to wait for that. We'll start building military factories immediately. Okay, 72 days, that's fair enough. So still standing at yeah. Hello Bulgarians. You'll never know what hit ya. Okay, as far as the tax. There it is. Research finished. I'm quite satisfied with how we are doing at the moment with industry. Gonna continue down this tree. Not bad. Have patience, guys. I trust you. It's gonna be real fun once the whole shit starts happening. Meanwhile, Japan and China still being really quiet. Okay, we just got ourselves another free military factory, so we can, yeah, get back here. The reason I also want to try and aim down this tree as fast as possible is the extra research slot we get. So we'll have four here instead of three. And that one can make a difference because you're basically studying four different texts at the same time. So I'm gonna go for the infrastructure effort. Also, we've got ourselves another free military factory to use. So I'm gonna add it to the heavy tank queue. Just to speed up the production a bit. Not much, but just a bit. Okay. Quite odd. No civil war in Spain yet. Japan is not waging war against China yet. I'm just waiting for that to happen, and now it should be happening quite soon. The way this map's gonna change. Yeah, I think we're definitely gonna align to the German Reich, because that's the only way we can survive early on. Anyways, we are in plus now with the Italians, and in plus with the Germans as well. We're studying army innovations. Industrial effort too is being studied by the Italians. Okay, they also have claims on Yugoslavia. Yeah, as a separate thing. This is something I like here, that not all the countries have the same tech tree. Most of them do, but the major powers like Italy will have it their own. Germany will have their own, Russia will have their own, USA as well. So we can modify our government again as we accumulated another 150 points. I'm seriously thinking of this. Seriously thinking of going radical. Daily fascism support gets events for fascism on the rise. But that's gonna make Germans like us. Okay, let's see. Should we go for this? Yeah, definitely. Oh dear. Have I made shit already? The younger generation will take up the torch. Yeah, what a lie. But we are definitely swapping to fascism now. Or moving towards it. Okay, free civilian factories, free military factories. So we've built the military factory we were yearning for. And we're gonna add another to production queue. Yeah, before you say it or ask or notice, I know that you can you know, add more, but the reason I'm doing it one by one is because I'm not sure as to, after finishing each of the factories, I'm not sure where I'll go from that step, because I'm just monitoring the situation, so therefore I'm just building one by one and occasionally swapping from military to civilian factory. Anyways, let's go and use the one remaining military factory we've built. Okay, we'll go this way. Sixty days, not bad. So we've got 8 points of experience or army experience. So in the deployment screen, I'm gonna add it. The tank division again by adding another heavy tank. Now notice that once you do that, all the existing divisions will be edited and tanks will be coming into them. Imagine we had like 50 tank divisions already and you go and edit it here, all the 50 will be getting that another battalion, but you'll just have to wait for the production queue. As you can see, this number now has jumped up. I don't remember what it was before, but it certainly was not 150, because that's the need now. We just, you know, did the editing of our division system, so we added another battalion of tanks to the division. So yeah, we need 150 now, 149, but we are working on constructing more military factories. Nuclear reactor, land fort. Naval base, coastal fort, that's great. Infrastructure efforts. Alright. Adds two building slots, adds two civilian factories. I like that. Okay, let's go this way. We are quite close to Hindenburg incident. The leak was promptly repaired. Had it gone unnoticed, flammable vapor could have resulted in a fire that would have engulfed the entire airship. Okay. Quite soon, these are going to be used in war as well. I wonder if you can produce them. Guess not. Okay, just going through the... Okay, we can choose for the night and day to be swapping. Let's see, how does that work? Don't notice anything, to be honest. Day-night loop. Maybe if I zoom in and zoom out, no. I don't know how that one should be working, but anyways. Okay. So, yeah, one more thing I wanted to tell you guys. You'll see this thing here. Now, this is a division we've chosen to build. This bar here shows the percentage of equipment they've got. Once they are at full equipment or fully equipped, and once they are fully trained, you'll get yourself a new up and running division. You can use them before they are fully equipped and fully trained, but that's not suggested by either the guys who made this game, or, you know, just imagine you give a 15-year-old an airplane without one wing, you know, that's pretty about that, you know, that's pretty much it. So you want your forces or your division to be fully trained and fully equipped before you send it to battle. Use those divisions that are not fully trained and fully equipped only if you really, really have to, if you're being overrun or attacked within your own borders, and you know, you just want to give the enemy some time or something to battle with before you get your reinforcements in or before your allies get to help. But otherwise, don't be sending the fully unprepared divisions into battle. All right, that's nice. Artillery, armor, light tank 2. All right, let's go for the light tank 2. Okay, we got ourselves another military factory built, and yeah, gonna do the same again. Also, we're now missing steel again, so yeah, we're gonna trade for it. We want to be fully produced in everything, which we are doing now. 70 days. Okay. I also know the next attack we'll go for. Oh, sorry, the national focus we'll go for. Once this one's done, we'll go for the construction effort 3, because that's gonna give us another two civilian factories. Okay, here it is. I've been wondering when's this gonna happen. The war between the nationalists and the republicans. Okay, Here it is. That's added some world tension. Soviet Union sending 3 volunteer divisions to Republic of Spain. Yeah, that's nice. I just wonder where exactly they're gonna pass. Oh, here's the night and day swap starting to happen. Let me see if I reduce the speed. Oh yeah, here it is. You can see the night coming. That's nice. Anyways, Amelia Earhart disappears. Oh, what a loss. I'll shed my tears over it. Thousands of millions of lives are to be lost within the next 5-6 years, so I think we can survive without Amelia. Modify our government. Let's see. Material designer. Small arms research time. Artillery research time. Authorization research time. National unity. Tank designers. Research time. Okay. We can reduce the research of anything related to tanks or ammo, which we are doing at the moment, I think. Yeah, studying light tanks. Concentrated industry coming up. That's great. Leadership purges in the Soviet Union. What's this? Whatever has been happening, the structure of the Soviet High Command has changed irrevocably. That's nice. Okay, let's see. Construction F-13. Definitely our pick of the moment. Well done, guys. We are sliming the industry. Production efficiency cap. Yeah, go for it. Okay, we are starting to rebuild. Yeah, we started with like 3 military factories, and I think we had like, can't remember really, but maybe like 5 civilian factories or something. Oh, sorry, 15. We're doing well at the moment. Here it starts. Okay. Wonder where the Marco Polo Bridge is. Okay. So, war to start anytime soon between Japan and China, and things happening already. Really, nationalists gonna win? Dear God, look at the sheer size of the Soviet Union. I mean, I know that the biggest part of it is inhabitable and so on, but this is just madness. Soviet Union itself is like bigger than most of the continents, if not the biggest. I'm not sure, I can't say it, but apart of course from the Asia, but Soviet Union alone might even be bigger than Africa or North America, not sure, but definitely bigger than Europe. Okay, I'm starting to regret, just looking at this picture, I'm starting to regret my aligning with the fascism and the Germans. And while being there, we might as well improve relations a bit with both you guys and you guys. Oh, you are guaranteeing the independence of Albania. That's interesting. So I suppose my plan of taking it falls into water. Okay, we've greatly reduced the needs of infantry equipment. We are now producing 33 per day, almost 34. And we've got ourselves a nice new factory to use. Okay, should we? Yeah, definitely we should continue with building military factories. Because anyway, soon we'll be getting another two civilian factories. Okay, I think we've done quite well with the industry for the moment. Let's see, weapons too. Arms. Okay, let's get a bit ahead of time, or at least be there. Okay, I like the reflection of the sun in the water. That looks nice. Okay. Yeah, we're there. I'm starting to go mad slowly. Construction effort finished. That's nice. We got ourselves two civilian factories, so we're gonna go for the extra research slot. So the war is just about start over here as well. I'm satisfied for the moment, I can tell you, with the industry we are reviving. Okay. It has started this very second. Yep. Whoa, that has added to some world tension, really. So, let's see, how is our division build going? Almost got it, almost there. Just 12 more heavy tanks. 11 now, and yeah, we'll get ourselves first division built. You can also see that it's first of first of many, or so to say, first of the unlimited number or amount that's gonna be produced. Once that one's done, you'll see number two appearing here. That will be that second one is being built, and you've built one. And until I remove it from here, it's gonna be building them, which I'm not gonna do. I'm not gonna remove, because I want armor that Yugoslavia doesn't have and didn't have. They actually had, but, you know, not the best of armor. So we now got ourselves 23rd division. We had a total of 22 before. We've now built our 23rd. When you zoom out, it's gonna join them into one flag or two flags, since we've got divisions on the edge here. It just, they don't stay precise. If you take a look at the flag, it'll show you as if they are in Italy, whereas they are here, but for some reason when you zoom out, it doesn't really show them where they are actually. But anyways, we've got ourselves the first division we've built. So you'll see that, let me just see. Yeah, one is being built, one has been finished. Alright, keep on pumping, guys. We want those armored divisions by 1940, want them a lot. Want them at least, well, 5 or 6 would be great. Fascist sympathies in the military, that's nice. That's really nice. By the way, how do you guys feel about us? And our own people also do not hate them, because we are aligning with the, as they are fascist as well, but also trade partners. So yeah, we are in a much better position now with the Germans and the Italians than we were at the beginning. Though our people still hate Italians. I think everybody hates Italians, so let's just improve the relations a bit more. Anyways, improved machine tools. Let's see. Constructed industry. Where do we go? Estonian infantry. Armor. Okay, go for it. I know it's a long one, but go for it anyways. We're gonna get ourselves a new research slot in 20 days. So, yeah. Okay, a few more things now I want to show you. Light tank 2 that we've just studied. Let me just pick something else from the branch. Okay, let's go for the medium tanks. We were talking about upgrading your units, and this is how it's done. Since you've now got light tanks too, you just need to swap it by clicking on it and choosing the light tank 2 from the list. So now it's going to be upgrading, and you can even see it here in the recruit and deployment screen. We've got upgrade requests. We've got 120 light tanks in total that now needs to be swapped from light tanks version 1 to light tanks version 2. So we can also give it a priority, but at the moment I want to build a few more of those divisions, so I'll just leave the priority as it is. Free civilian structures. Let's build another Vojvodina. Another military factory, and I've got a free military factory to assign as well. Okay, and we'll also need to trade for the steel as we are missing it now. Okay, so we are building 36. If you remember, at some point when we started the infantry equipment, it was terrible. It was something like 15,000 or 10,000 needed, I can't remember exactly, but we are going there now. We're getting there. Also, we are now producing almost, let's say, 21 or 22 tanks, heavy tanks, per month, which is not bad, really. So, yeah, doing fine. For the moment, preparing for the war, recovering our fallen industry from the First World War, and getting ready for the shit that's gonna escalate quite soon. Here it is, the extra research slot. Italy announces claims in Yugoslavian territory. You assholes. Really? What do you claim? Piece of shit, no wonder we hate you. Alright, well, I don't know, I just hope to stay good with this guy. Because, yeah, that'd be a strange thing. Me aligning with Germany and then Italy attacking us. And potentially we get a conflict of Italy and Germans, that'd be really funny. So we have an extra research slot now. Yeah, we can go for the extra research slot too, because we need more than 50 factories. We've got 37 in total for the moment, but political effort, army effort. Okay, let's go for the army effort. And let's select our new slot. See what we're gonna study. Yeah, well, let's start with artillery. We don't have artillery, we're gonna be adding it to divisions as well. Okay, let's add another heavy tank here and save it, and therefore the number here is gonna pop. Jump up again, but I don't care, we want those divisions being strong. So now, yeah, looking much better now. Modify our government again. Let's see. Dignity. Da, da, da. Chief of Army. Civilian economy. Partial mobilization. Yeah, we're gonna go for that. It's gonna speed up the construction of military factories as well. Okay. Yeah, bad weather around here. Even the clouds sense what's gonna happen quite soon. Sorry guys, if you don't mind, I'm just gonna light a smoke. And even if you guys mind, piss off, because you're not breathing it in. I'm waging a war and I'm nervous. Alright, let's see. More free civilian factories and free military factories. So we should continue building them. 40 days only, that's great. Let's get to the production and see where do we assign you. Okay, yeah, good thing I've gone in to check. As you can see now, infantry equipment needs are fulfilled. So I'll reduce it back to 1 and now we'll have 4 spare. I'm afraid we're also gonna lack, yeah, as I thought, we're gonna lack oil for this trade. So, hello Romania, here we are again. I believe you could use some factories. Just give us the oil we need. And yeah, we've come to 1 per day now, so that's good. That's good. Now we're producing about 30 heavy tanks a month. So with this tempo, it'll take us like 6 or 7 months to fulfill all the needs. That's good. Okay, we're gonna set high priority for the upgrades as well. We wanna start upgrading those light tanks. So now we need like 40 days or less before we get ourselves a new tank division. Second one is being built at the moment. Support weapons 2 and artillery. Once we finish with artillery, we'll use the slowly growing army experience points to add artilleries to both our infantry and tank divisions. Okay, so we are now officially the neighbors of Germany because the Anschluss of Austria just happened, which means yeah, the German Reich now spreads all the way to the north of Yugoslavia. Weapons, motorized. Power. Okay, let's go for the political power. The reason I went for that is that I want to further on increase the support towards fascism and kill all the democracy that's left in the country. As you can see, this gonna the effect of this tech. The next one we're gonna be studying grants daily democracy support minus 0.02, which is not much on a daily basis, but accumulated through a few months or a year, it counts. Let's see, where can we go from here? Let's try to further reduce the research time of new techs. Okay, satisfied with this. And there's another military factory being built. Here we'll go for another one. And let's also assign the one we got. Let's give it to the light tanks. Now we lack steel, so yeah. The Germans gonna give us some for the factories they'll always need. It's okay, we are not lacking any resources again. 4.4, 4.5 a week, so let's say we're making like something towards 18 a month. So we'll need like 5 months to upgrade all the light tanks we have in our divisions from light tanks 1 to light tanks 2. And quite soon we're gonna start building artillery. Okay, this division has all the equipment it needs. We're just waiting for the training, which is gonna be fulfilled or finished on the 11th of May 1938. Just about 2 months from now. So we'll already have fresh 2 divisions of mixture of just a little of light tanks and a lot of heavy tanks. So we've given Yugoslavia the armor they've never had, or they had some crappy light tanks from 15th century. We've also managed to improve their industry a lot. Material designer. Small arms research time, yeah, let's go for that. That's gonna improve all the support weapons. Tech tree is just stunning. Right. That's nice. Okay, let's see. Where do we go from here? Yeah, let's further on improve on the artillery. And we could also, let me just see. Alright, as soon as we are finished with this military factory, which is just about now, I'm gonna build a few civilian factories again. Though they take much more time to complete, but we'll need them. And we shall start building artillery. We're gonna edit the infantry divisions and gonna add support artillery. Add it here, that's a total of 20. All right, and we're gonna put them in production line. So we have one free military factory only for the moment. We're gonna swap around because we need plenty of artillery now. But quite soon we'll have all the needs for the heavy tanks fulfilled, so we're gonna swap many of those factories towards building artillery. Okay, yeah, collective eaters. Let's see. National unity plus 15%. The bigger the national unity, I think that has pretty much been the same through all House of Iron games. The bigger the national unity, the more willing your people are to fight. I think it even says, represents the willingness of the people at the top to prosecute the war to the finish. The higher this value is, the longer they'll fight on before considering surrender. So, yep. Also, we'll need tungsten for the artillery we are building. Let's just see whom do we let's start trading with Soviets as well. Maybe that's gonna improve our relations with them just a bit. Better our relations with them even. Yeah, they don't pretty much like us. Let's start improving relations with them as well. Treaty of Madrid, national in Spain, took 7 states. Republican Spain was annexed. 1300 equipment has been seized. Okay, so we've got national in Spain. This goes well for us in case we are planning to align with the Germans, as we do. Because the nationalists of Spain are fascist as well, so Francisco Franco. Yeah, he is gonna hold our side as well. We can expect them to attack France when Germany does so. Okay, so we're gonna be getting new tank division in just a week or less. That's good. Military factories. So as soon as we are finished building this one civilian factory, we might go back to building military factories again. Okay, we've produced the second one, so the third one's gonna be ready in November. Looking fine. See where we stand with Germans. We still love each other. Okay, that's nice. We're gonna be improving the relations further on with both Italians and Germans. We are also doing so with Russians already. Sorry, oof. Stood up for a second and discovered that the globe is round. Okay. Oh, I like this steel title on the top of the map. And even the music is trying to tell you that a lot of shit is gonna happen quite soon. Now waiting for the tension to rise just a bit more, and we might even go for Bulgaria quite soon. And we'll see how that one is gonna play out. Okay, that's nice. Now let's see, Jerusalem, daily communism support, daily fascism support. Yeah, we're gonna go farther on for the fascism support. A lot of artillery to be made in order for it to be implemented into the army or into the existing divisions. Yeah, Okay, let's give it the highest priority now. Reinforcements. Because we want to fill up our divisions. Six a week. With this tempo, we're not gonna finish by 1970. But the good thing is, we're finally gonna get our heavy tanks off the neck, because as of 2 days from now, we're gonna have our needs for the heavy tank production filled, so we'll be able to reallocate all those. Yeah, great. All those military factories. We can just add a few here. To the light tank, and we've got like 5 remaining we can add here, so we'll reach 186 a day. Should we go for a military factory now again? Or let me see how much would it take for a civilian factory to be produced. Yeah, okay, let's go for another civilian factory, because we'll need them for trade. Okay, so if we make around 2 a day, that'll be like 14 a week. So it'll be like 55, 56 a month, multiplied by 10, 5, 7, like 650 a year it will be. So, yeah, still not the best of shots, but we are getting there. From the Turlu 2, let's see. Already studying this. Too early for atomic research. Production efficiency cap. Yeah. Go for it. Okay. So this one will be done in November. Tension at 35%, still waiting for it to reach the all famous 50. Okay. Unfulfilled import requests. Yeah, that happens when you have an ongoing trade deal with some of the countries that are for that moment unable to fulfill it again. Like whether they lost their territory or they've exported too much or whichever. Okay, just a second, too many things happen at the moment. Munich Agreement. What a lie that was. France and Britain announced alliance. Yeah. Nationalism focus, we've just done that. Militarism, effective partisan, some experience. Critical population, 5% infection, yeah, we might go for that. Let's just see. Lot of nice and neat things around here. Don't know where to go first. Okay, I think this is fine. Meanwhile, our manpower is really low. Gotta somehow increase the manpower. Let's see how can we exactly do it. Partial mobilization, extra focus, volunteer only, limited conscription. Disarmed nation. Okay, let's go for the limited conscription. And immediately we get 145,000 people at our disposal, which is great from the 400 guys we had. Doubt where to go. Okay, land doctrines. We might go here. We got all these little bonuses from the text we've studied already. Superior firepower, trench warfare, mass assault. So, no. Breakthrough, Nemstatic Aspect, Trust, Planning Speed, Division Speed. Yeah, I think we're gonna go for this one. Start working on doctrines. Come on, Germany, go mad. I want the world's tension to rise. We wanna declare war on Bulgaria. Actually, we'll have to justify a war goal first. Meanwhile, what's our relation with you? I'm gonna need for improvements at the moment. What about you guys? We could be improving with you, especially since you're having claims on our own land. And we're looking fine with the Ruskies. Yeah, they're sending volunteers. They're sending volunteers to Chinese. Let's see how that war progresses. Oh yeah, Chinese are eating up the Japan. I think they're gonna pause them back to their homeland. That's not good for us. We need strong Japan if we are to align with Germany. Civil war for fascism. Oh shit. They must unite the people first, then rule them. I don't want a fucking war within my own borders, with my own people for the moment. Don't need that shit. Let's see. 37 days until the factory. Looking good. Okay, light tanks have finished producing everything they need. We'll get back to it. Just give new orders for you guys. Okay, medium tank will be finished quite soon. Weapons 2, go for it. Now, the free military factories we've got. Need a lot. Mm-hmm. 37 days. I don't wanna give my civilian factory for the tungsten at the moment, so I'll leave it to work at this rate until our construction has been completed, until we get another civilian factory. So research slots available. Let's see. Yeah, we are too ahead with the heavy tanks for the moment. So, we could... support battalions. Oh, sorry. Yeah, we could go for the motorized first. Yeah, I think just about that time. So we'll wait, as I said before, we get tungsten. We'll wait. 5 days, a decent rate. It's like 150 a month. Not bad. But we'll wait just for this to be built, and then we'll swap it. We'll trade it for tungsten. Okay, let's see. How are we going with the deployment screen or recruit screen? Yeah, November is getting closer. Our third division is getting ready to pop on the field. Yeah, I don't want war. Unite the people, you fucking bastards. We want a united Yugoslavia. Yeah, the fascists are going up 30% now. As of this moment. And climbing, and Democratic Party is just still falling. Right. Not going bad for the moment. The interesting years are yet to come. It's now the end of 1938. Still peaceful. Germans still not attacking Poland. Equipment effort has been finished. Okay, let's go for the motorization efforts. And free civilian factory, that means you guys finished the civilian factory you were supposed to build. Now if I give you to build another civilian factory, how much would it take you? 94 days, da-da-da-da-da-da. Shush. Yeah, go for another one, and as far as the resources are concerned, here we go for the tungsten. Let's get you guys your tungsten so you can build at full rate. So now instead of 5, we have 7.3 a day or thereabouts. So that'll be like 50 a week, 200 a month. And we'll need about 5 months to get the total of 1,000 artillery. But yeah, working on it. We also finished studying medium tanks, which we are going to bring in to the army slowly. Let's see, the doctrines, the next one gives organization plus 15. I don't mind that. Alright, Yugoslavs. So we've built our turret and we are... What? Fascist assault divisions form. Okay, change in popularity of fascists 5%, gains national spirit fascist assault divisions, which grants national unity minus 5%, recruitable population 0.20, daily fascism support plus 0.5. Okay, so we don't have the 75% we had again, but nevertheless, it seems we are definitely, they are more and more popular. Fascist assault division, that's great. What do you Germans say about that? Yeah, we love each other, I know. We love you too. What about you, asshole? We hate you anytime, any day. Minguo has capitulated. I'm so sorry for that, really. It really touches me. Okay. Production. Yay, we are beneath 1,000 now with the artillery needs. Finally. Okay. I know you guys can't wait for the shit to start happening, neither can I, but this is probably most boring part of the game, the preparation by a minor country. Preparation for the war by a minor country, actually, I suppose that playing as Germans or Soviets, the preparations can be quite interesting. But with a little we've gotta go slowly. We gotta take it slowly. But what we can do is start training infantry divisions as well. Okay, you're gonna start adding infantry divisions as well. Okay, so we are building 2 a week, 9 a day. Okay, just a few more months for the artillery needs to be fulfilled. Another civilian factory coming up. Modify our government again. I think it's just about time we started adding. We started adding some military staff, which we still don't have. Yeah, 28 civilian factories, 13 military factories. Not bad, not bad. Or not bad to compared to what we started with. Certainly bad compared to the major powers, but I think we might be looking better than Bulgaria now in terms of industry. Now, an interesting thing that Italy still didn't seize Albania, so I really hope that stays that way until the world tension rises, so we can maybe grab that land for ourselves. Let's see, mechanization. Okay, go for it. Some of the techs will greatly reduce the head of time penalty you get when you want to discover a technology that's like, you know, based from technology assets in, like, for example, 1941. You want to get it in 1939. Yeah, it's gonna have a huge ahead of time penalty. That way the creators of the game wanted to avoid, you know, the situations where you'll be dropping nukes in 1937. So some of the techs can greatly reduce, or national focuses actually can greatly reduce that ahead of time penalty. Okay, so we are now at 41. That's nice, we're getting close to 50. Ah, look at the way they love us. They are currently studying the fate of Czechoslovakia. Where is that? Befriend China, really? Just looking at those, quite odd. Yeah, quite odd. Their national focus tree. I've gotta play it as Germans once just to see how this functions. Anyways, let's get back to the field. What about the Ruskies? Do you hate us? No, you don't. Alright, in the name of that, I'll start improving my relations with you. But I'm gonna do it with you guys as well. And I'm gonna do it with you guys as well. No, not yet. I don't give a fuck about the United States for the moment. I know this war is gonna cost me a lot at some point, but don't wanna do it yet. Machine tools. Okay. Repair speed. Research gain efficiency. Yeah, you can do it. Okay, so this division is gonna be ready in May, and this one's gonna be ready in June. We'll get our fourth division. Okay. No, don't drop down, please. Don't drop down. Yay! Finally, the radical party has become the ruling party. No public elections. Reign of Terror, which grants political power gain plus 10% for 730 days. That's good for 2 years. Oh, our flag just changed. Yeah. And the Prince Paul that used to rule the country is not there again, but we've got Milan Stojadinović, the radical guy. So we are now officially ruling the country as a fascist, and you can even see it written. Oh, just starting to love this game. You can even see it written Radical Yugoslavia, or in Serbian, Radikalna Yugoslavia. But what won my heart now is this little detail they've put in of flag change. Anyways, sorry. We've got 3 civilian buildings. We're gonna use them, to build another military factory now. Yeah, 47 days needed. That also means we've got just about enough to pump into artillery again. So 13 a day. We'll need just below 10 days to finish the damn production of the artillery and have all our divisions filled up with the artillery. So yeah, infantry has a lot of artillery. We've given them, I don't think we've given tank battalions artillery, no. But we should give them a support artillery. We should give them, no enough arm experience for engineering company. And let's give these guys artillery as well. So more artillery needs to be built now, but since we are having a good overall daily production, this number is gonna be down pretty quick. We need just 10 days to produce half of it, so 20 days will be done with artillery itself. Okay, night preparations for war we've done anyways. Infantry equipment 2 done. Support weapons 3. Oop, sorry. Well done, well done. Looking fine. Just finish with the artillery. Motorized infantry as well. We're gonna have to wait because we don't have enough army experience to be tampering with editing our divisions now, but we'll be doing that quite soon. Let's see, where do we go from here? Okay, we can go for this. Heavy artillery. We could use some of those guys. Why not? Let's see the production screen. Oh, just a second, let's see. How are we standing here? 16 days to complete, that's great. Okay, so the needs for artillery are fulfilled. We've got 3 military factories. We've got 8 of them free. So one more. Yeah. We're now missing steel. What? What? You guys are out of steel, really? Okay, turn to Soviets. Please give us some steel. So much for peace. Let's see. Okay. So checks are no more. Armor technology bonus. Gonna go for that. So we need 50 more heavy tanks. We're now producing 4 a week. Zerg submits to Italy. All right. 44% of the world tension, and I think we're getting there. We're just about to get to the 50% we need. Okay, almost all our needs are fulfilled except for the heavy tanks, which we are still building. Need 45 more for the to cover all the needs. 28th of June, okay, April, May, June, so 2 months from now we'll have another division. And soon we'll have the first newly built infantry division on the post of May. That's just 10 days or something like that from now. Yeah, looking good, looking good. Just completed another military factory. So how much would you need to build a civilian factory now? 103 days, dear lord. Okay, go for it. What can we do? We'll need you to trade. We've got a free military factory we're gonna use for the heavy tanks. So we're now building like 22 a month. So 1.5 months from now, we'll have all the needs fulfilled and we can finally start editing our divisions again and adding medium tanks to them. Maybe add some more artillery or the mobile artillery we are studying. We might be adding that as well. Yeah. Let's see, where do we go? And do we... Okay, let's try and modernize the fighters a little bit. Because our air support is really terrible. So let's try and modernize it to the 1939 year. Okay, so we are having 26 divisions now. We've built 4. But we didn't build many divisions, but we've modernized our army greatly. Okay, 19 heavy tanks more. Come on. Alright guys, excuse me for just a second. Okay, I'm sorry I kept you waiting, just had to do something quickly. No, I was not going to shit or pee. Just had to take my meds, as I'm coughing like an asshole for the past few days. Let's see, modify our government. Let's go to the military again. Okay. I'll choose you. I'll choose you just for the sake of armor. I love. 44%. Come on, climb up. Okay, these guys are already building the second division, which is gonna come out on the September. Okay, do the heavy tank. Yep. We can continue stockpiling, which we are not going to do. Let's just see. I've got 7 points of farm experience. Let me just see what could we do. What I think I'm gonna do is I'm gonna add. No, sorry. Just a second, let's sure trying to check on something. Oh yeah, heavy support artillery. Yeah, here it is. I'm gonna add the heavy support artillery. Save it, and I will start producing the heavy support artillery. Large artillery piece mounted on heavy chassis. These self-propelled guns carry a lot of firepower. Okay, so if we start producing new, we need 150 of those. So let's see. Well, suddenly get quite a bunch of free military factories. If we give you those. Okay, that's nice. Oh yeah, we need infantry equipment as well. I forgot about it. Dear God, look at the amount of infantry equipment we need to make. I totally forgot about this. We've got to modernize our infantry equipment. I studied it, but I forgot to add it. But okay, we'll do it now. It's just gonna take some time. Field hospital. Let's go for that and add that to our infantry. That's always useful. Italy joined the Axis. All right. Meanwhile, we've got our armor efforts. Italy pursues closer bonds with Germany. I know. Doctrine effort. Okay. Let's see, where do we go from here? Now in a doubt. Okay, we'll definitely move on toward bans communism. That's great. All right. So waiting for tension to escalate above 50. It's almost there. Yeah, building up to K3. I think, I'm not sure, but I think the more we make of those, the faster they start to make them. So I think that this number grows over time. Slowly, but yeah, obviously, yes. It's growing over time. And it's growing almost on a daily basis. From what I noticed for like 0.05. Yeah. Okay. So what I'm gonna do is, once we build about enough of those artillery support vehicles, I'm gonna transfer all these industries to infantry equipment too. Okay, continue working on excavation. Another tactic. We got an organization plus 15 from delay. We're gonna study now. Bička puterica. Okay, let's see. Oh, come on, really? I'm gonna wait for the tension to rise. Germans, just do something. Slap somebody in the face. We need that at 50. Oh yeah, Italy has come in officially. They are now in Albania, so I suppose we're gonna have to turn towards Bulgaria as our first aim. Definitely. No doubt at the moment now. We could go for the Romania, but what I'm afraid of, they'll be like, you know, much better option due to the already mentioned oil fields they've got. But since I suppose they are in quite good relations with Germans, or they will at some point become, maybe it was happening to me, they're gonna align with Germany and Italy. So I think I'm risking war versus Germany much more in case of attacking Romania than I do it by attacking Bulgaria. For all you Bulgarians watching, sorry to say this, but at the moment I think in the game, nobody cares for Bulgaria, so yeah. Italy is growing relations with Bulgaria, funnily enough. But we already said once that we don't give a fuck about Italians. They just come in package with Germany, you know, so it's like, you know, when you see one of those hot chicks somewhere in the club and you approach her and she always has some ugly fat friend with her, a girl. So, you know, if you win that cute, hot chick, the package that comes with her is her ugly friend. So, yeah, here, the package that comes with Germans are the Italians. Nothing you can do about it. Anyways, let's move on towards building more factories, actually more military factories. Because we're gonna need them. Let me just see. Okay, here's how we're gonna do it now. I'm gonna leave this just a bit more just to get below 100. That's the need for the support artillery. Actually, I don't give a fuck. I'm not going to wait. I want to start modernizing the infantry as soon as possible, which is now, so 16 a day already makes a difference. A day now, so yeah. Okay, this one increases more. Let's see by how much. Yeah, by 0.3. Poland refuses German ultimatum. What a mistake. Yeah, go for it. So almost 20 a day. Okay, that's what we were waiting for. Anyways, almost 20 a day, we'll be making 600 a month. We'll need about a year to modernize all of our infantry equipment, but for the moment we've got the wall tension above 50%, so we're gonna start justifying a war goal towards Bulgaria so we can attack them. We'll set taking Sofia as our war goal. Right. Poland joined allies. Anglo-Polish alliance. Things are moving fast now, but yeah, too late. Too late for you guys, because they're gonna blitzkrieg you within a few weeks or a month at most. Okay, they're trying to encircle the capital, which they might as well do once they take this and maybe cut through. We'll see. I'll be quite surprised if the AI does that. Come on, make my day and encircle them. Though they are leaving nice little pockets of encirclement, you gotta admit that. The weather is also not going into German's favor. But they're doing their thing slowly, slowly but surely. 23 a day, 660 a month, yeah. Okay, another military factory is ready, up and running. The fall of Warsaw and Poland is doomed. Okay, we'll continue constructing military factories. See, we can add the military factory towards infantry equipment. Continue producing it as much as possible. Okay, Eastern Poland has fallen as well. But the German Reich has grown after tearing Czechs. Anschlussing Austria, now defeating Poland. And I was just gonna say that Belgium, Netherlands and Luxembourg are next. Okay, that was quick, like what, 2 days? Okay, so we are still, yeah, in a great relations with Germans. Somewhat good relations, or actually great relations with Italians. It's just that our people hate Italians. On the other hand, they somewhat like the German Reich. Modifying government, military high command, let's see, infantry division, attack and defense. We are getting ready for the war. Yeah, Netherlands joined the Allies. You all remembered to join the Allies after the Germans attack you, you assholes. You should have seen it coming. So, this tank division is gonna come out on the 6th of October. Or that is, in case they get the artillery they need, which they aren't getting now, so German Reich declared war. Yeah, I'm gonna return this back to the artillery. Because I want the artillery to be trained in order for divisions to appear. Shit starting to happen. Okay, someone's not Giving enough oil. Okay, it just changed. Someone didn't have enough to give. Insufficient resources. Yeah, Romania is not delivering. Okay, let's go for the Soviets. Okay, we've got the basic fighters, but let's go for the fighters from the 1940, and then we'll start producing them as well. Come on. Heavy SP artillery. We need to build those. We need them a lot, and we need them quite quickly. Okay, let's see how he's justifying war goal versus Bulgarian's coin. I think that it can be seen somewhere. Progress 68, expected to finish 15th of February. Okay, so November, December, January, February, in about 4 months we'll be able to declare war on Bulgaria. Okay. Yeah, this is now stagnant as we need more heavy support artilleries being built in order to conclude the tank division. Well done. We shouldn't have that much of a tough time, but they do have plenty of units. I mean, plenty. We can't see what they've got. We, I guess, have more, but again, our own units should be more modern, if nothing else. And they're having a good artillery support, or at least a modern artillery support. Though we haven't modernized it to the best of its possibilities, since we still have... Oh, we still didn't study the artillery 2. Okay, Paris has fallen. Okay, we are starting to fill up the artillery needs, finally. So 5 a week, 4 weeks will give us like 20 something. Since it's 5.5 or 5.6. Okay, France is doomed. And we are officially at 100% of the world tension. We also got ourselves field hospital. That's nice. Field hospital. Get the field hospital too. And guess what? He'll be building a military factory. Aren't you surprised about that? Who would say? Also, let's see. We want to add military or field hospital to our infantry divisions. So we also want to... An interesting thing now. It says missing equipment production. Motorized. Okay, so in order to have the military... in order to have the military, or sorry, the field hospital functioning, obviously we need the motorized. And now we need rubber, so let's see, whom can we steal the rubber from? Soviets, Brazil, Southern France, Netherlands are too far. Okay, let's go for it. Need 20 of motorized to be produced. Heavy support artillery, we're doing fine with it. Okay, what happened? times. Under the terms of the armistice, the French government under Marshal Pétain, be that official, will continue to administer most of the southern France while the rest of the country falls under German occupation zone. Some French officers have vowed to continue resisting from abroad, but this puts an effective end to fighting in France, at least for the time being. Okay, so... ship in a dramatic end today when it exploded over Scotland. I don't give a fuck about that, to be honest. Let's see. Yeah, we're getting most of the needs filled. Speaks against Bulgaria. That's great. Does Bulgaria belong to the Bulgarian? What a question. Really? Do you think that Bulgaria belongs to Bulgarian? Let us ask ourselves a better question. Does the future belong to the Bulgarian? Who are Bulgarians? The Bulgarians even deserve to live or something. This guy, I love him. His speech. Does Bulgaria even belong to Bulgarians? That's great. Excavation 2. Okay, we'll need repair factory for some point. Come on, guys. 30th November. We just need 5 more artillery pieces in order to deploy the fresh division. They're starting to look scary. We've got heavy tanks, we've got artillery support, we've got artillery on the field as well, we've got heavy support artillery. As far as it concerns the infantry, we are having artillery and field hospital as well. So we're doing fine, we're doing fine. And we're also flooding low manpower. No, it's not. We still have 120,000 available, so stop shitting. But there's a way to add more manpower, I think. Maybe by... let me just see. Maybe one of those things. Yeah. So we'll go for the militarism next. Definitely to add more manpower. What's our relations with Russians? Not that bad. Let's improve it just a bit more. What about you, Italians? Okay, not bad. Germans, we should be fine. Yeah, and we also somewhat think nicely of you. The Soviet Union declared war on Lithuania. Okay, so... what did we say again? When do we get the right to attack? 15th of February, alrighty. So... 2 more months! 2 more months only! And we'll have another infantry division built. Or a third one, so basically we've built 4. Until now we have built 4 tank divisions and... we'll build 3 until the war begins of infantry division, so a total of 7, but we've modernized them, which is much more important. We also stabilized the industry, though we are lacking civilian factories again, but we also built plenty of military factories, and we're gonna get a few more by conquering Bulgaria. Seeds, Bessarabia to Soviet Union, yeah. Yeah, without the war. After massing forces along the Romanian border, the Soviet Union has issued an ultimatum to the government in Bucharest for the immediate transfer of Bessarabia to their control. The region once belonged to the Russian Empire, which the Soviet Union sees as a sufficient legal basis for their demands. Romania has declared that it has no choice but to accede, and its forces have been withdrawn from Bessarabia. So without a fight, you've given up, you pussies. Okay, let's modify our government. Division attrition. Okay. We've modified our military command just about in time. Or just about before the war is to begin from our side. So yeah. Finally, the first step we're gonna take. The Bulgarians. It's gonna happen quite soon after. Okay, let's do a little sum up. We've been reconstructing the industry, we've built armor which Yugoslavs didn't have, and we've modernized the existing infantry divisions. Okay, let's see. Militarism, we want more manpower. On the other side, let's see. Okay. Japan joined the Axis, that's great. We'll need 30 more days and all the artilleries will be fulfilled, so then we can transfer to the motorized infantry and to the infantry equipment that we are missing. We'll be able to start modernizing that, and perhaps after that start building fresh fighters. Japan still managing. Okay. That's nice. From two different sides. Interesting. Alright. Was this not sure? Was this? Can't click on it. Don't know what that is, to be honest. Have to check that out. Okay, 26th of 27th of January. What did we see again? 15th of February. Come on, I'm really impatient. What we can do and what we are going to do for certain is what is the total number of divisions we've got? 28. So, we are going to do it this way. Those two, and you guys, that will make 22 divisions. 24 divisions will create an army. And we'll add, let's see, tag defense movement. Okay, we'll choose Ivan Gosniak. And we'll also. Now, just to clarify something, yeah, once you create an army, you get various, so to say, orders you can be given. One of them is like, let's see, the front line. Now, since I know I'm going to invade Sofia, I'm gonna set the front line be here. After that, you can be given, you know, orders for them to puncture through the enemy territory. You can make this so-called battle plans. That's a new thing. But sometimes the units know how to behave quite oddly. Like if you give them a battle plan to reach this frontier here, you know, they may start choosing some various paths and different angles. I know they're trying to encircle and stuff, but you know, they'll leave like a few territories with just one division on it and then pile up plenty of divisions inside and so on and so on. So what I do, just give them front line in order for them to get there. After that, I delete any orders and give the orders manually to the divisions, but just leave the army be with the commander as they are getting bonuses from his own, you know, being there. Basically, I believe that these military plans have been implemented that when playing as a major power, you know, like for example Italy, France, the Germans, Soviets, USA, and so on and so on, you'll be striking many fronts, you know. So to take every division in each territory, you know, and be pinpointing and, you know, giving manual orders, that'll be a mess. So you've got the military plans or battle plans that you can give, for the you know, units to be advancing towards, where they rest, where they, when will they reorganize, and so on and so on. But in case we have, or actually as we do, have a Pony army compared to those guys, to the major powers, we'll be doing all this manually. So I'll just use okay, here it is. Questions the motives of Bulgaria. I'll just use this to, you know, move the guys. I'll just use the plans to move the guys to the frontier. We've also got three civilian and military factories, so I think it's time to build a few civilian factories, though it's gonna take ages. You also have one free military factory. Okay, let's assign it here. And once this is done, we can go and try to reorganize the infantry equipment. Okay, so I want you guys to reach the place, but I also want mountaineers to get here. And I also want you guys to reach this place. Okay, so I'm going to now delete an existing orders, because I want to tell them where, I'll tell them manually where to come. So I want one division here, one tank division here. Let me see, I want you guys, you, I want you here. Okay, let's see what's happening. You here. Okay, the Romania joined Axis. So that was a smart decision, not trying to justify a war goal against Romania. Turns out to be a smart decision after all. And 5 days more, we'll be able to declare war. Here. You can come here. Small. Yes, we are getting prepared. Okay, so we've managed to justify our war goal. Just gonna hold out for a few more minutes until all the forces approach, and we are going to declare war on them. Meanwhile, let's check our production queue. So, need field. Okay. All right, let's check it out and see if everything stands as we would like. Just wasted a lot of civilian factories for trade. That is why we are missing them now. Okay, so Bulgarians, are you aware of what awaits you? Just finished elastic defense. That's great. It couldn't have been at a better moment. Okay, let's continue with the land doctrine. Are you all guys there? Yes, you are. gonna leave on purpose this pocket here and perhaps, just perhaps, maybe mess the AI of trying to enter the land. And I think we are ready to declare the war against Bulgarians. Conquer. Okay, conquer. Yeah, we can. Oh, we don't have allies yet. So we just declared the war. We've got air wings with no mission. Let's see. Eastern Balkans. Okay. But we don't want you in the Eastern Balkans. In the Western Balkans, we want you. How do I know? How do I change this to... Not sure. I can see that it's written Western Balkans. Okay, left click. So now you'll be attacking Eastern Balkans, or actually you'll be doing an interception. All right. Well done. Yeah, this is our own bunny plane. Okay. Let's see, where do we start from? I'm gonna reduce this to half of the speed. Alright. I think we're gonna go straight for you. And try and attack this place from multiple directions. Try and break through this place. Joined the battle from there, but we might actually cut him off. Whoa, really? You guys are losing. Okay, tough fighting going on here. Let's see, why is that so? We've got 5 versus 3 divisions. Enemy has the air superiority, okay, I understand that. Okay, we're gonna retreat to this place and play defensively from that place. Okay, yeah. They're trying to encircle us, so let's do it. Let them keep attacking, or do we enter Sofia? I'll just hold it out a bit more. Okay, you as well. Let's try and enter Sofia. We'll give them the northern part of the border without any problem. Let them enter. Though they've cut us off, but we'll let it be. To Sofia and attack from the rear. Let's just try and break this point once we get this. Okay, shit, hurry up. Can't you see that the guys cut off? Hurry up, hurry up, hurry up, hurry up, hurry up, hurry the fuck up. Side as well. Okay, that's good. That's good. So all of you guys can rest there and play it defensively. I can see they're trying to progress to the north. But believe me. Let's see. We'll send like 5 divisions here. Leave the remaining to fight defensively. Okay, play it defensive. trying to cut them off. They're holding the city. Come on, break them through, break them through, break them through. Military factories. Okay, construction. Yeah, we've got three. Invite this action. Alright, we'll accept. We'll accept. We've just changed the history already, as Yugoslavia was never part of the Reich. Let's just see what are we going to continue to produce and then try and chase the Bulgarians off. Okay, 18 a day. Let's keep it that way now. I know it just looks bad for the moment, but trust me guys, it's gonna turn towards our own side quite quickly. Just managed to cut them off here. Come on. Take that, we'll be able to be sweeping them towards Plovdiv. Alright. So, you guys can start cutting them up. Well done. Continue pursuing the stuff now. Guys off or slamming you, we'll cut you off, but from this side. So they've beaten the trap. Guys are progressing. Okay. Yeah, I can tell you they're giving us tough time, but nevertheless, continue pursuing them. Okay, they are retreating, they see what's coming. You have come here as well. Field hospital too. Okay, dear God. Game options. I just reduced the audio, I didn't even is the amount of banging this was producing. Okay, let's just see, not that much. We want to hear some of the noise. Something like this. Okay, let's see. I can see that you are having issues winning this, so maybe leave them be, leave them move towards Belgrade. You can come help out. Okay, now quickly attack them, chase them out of there. Don't know how, but I want you to do it. You get him while he has no support, so let me just see. Already doing this. Okay, cut him off. I know he's going towards Belgrade, that's more than obvious, but leave them be. As I said already, they'll capitulate quite soon. Okay. We can start chasing you guys directly from Sofia. So we'll create this nice neat pocket on the north, and most likely they won't be able to escape it. Okay, and this battle is also approaching its end. You're not going anywhere. You guys might just help out. Okay. We're missing equipment production. We'll deal with that already. Just see. 160 of motorized. Okay. So now that you're cut up. Look at this stinky asshole. What do you fucking think? Get here. You horses, get here. One of you, get here. And you guys, help out. Cut them off on the north. Let's see. Okay, so they've beaten the initial plan we had from the beginning, where we left a small pocket for them to enter. I don't know whether I should be happy with that or not, because it just shows you can trick the AI. On the other hand, I'm proud that my plan actually succeeded. So yeah, now that they're cut up, they're literally fucked up. Their supply line will be doomed. And yeah, they're not gonna withstand it for much more. Anyways, let's see how does the war go for the moment. We've got 28 divisions. They've got anywhere between 14 and 24, with 14,000 losses of our own and 31,000 of their own. I could have called the allies, which I'm gonna do now. Have I done it? Yeah, just for the sake of, I should have done it before, just for the sake of air superiority, because they'll come and be bombing them, and that is something I should have been doing, but you know, it doesn't matter now. Okay, so let's continue progressing over here. You guys are doomed. I'll let you be. Reorganize and let's destroy them. Okay, they are retreating. We are covering all the lines. They're also, yeah, feeling nice now. Okay, you guys have finished. You can come and reinforce the front line, and okay, we can now bring those units back to the frontier as well. You should come here, you should come here, and the three of you can come help out here as a major force. Okay, all looking great. You can go just about anywhere. Come join your fellows. Okay. Yeah, we get 17,000 casualties, but casualties of the Bulgarians are 64,000, so we are doing well. Their divisions are exterminating slowly. And now, once we reinforce our front lines with the guys that were chasing the Bulgarians that were trying to reach Belgrade. Okay, so now everyone joined. Everybody joined in the war against Bulgaria. Okay, so we have now reinforced our border lines. Okay, you guys just stay back for the moment. Get back here. Let's just reinforce. Catch breath and do one final hit. Okay. Pushing, guys. Well, and you guys can push in as well. So we're gonna send one tank division and let's see, two infantry divisions to Plovdiv, and the rest of you guys. Okay, they've given up. They've given up initially, or finally. They want to take all the states. Oh shit, we don't have enough for score for it. Mm-hmm. All right. Let's see. Want to take Sofia at least. Let's pass. So we want to take all states. All right, we managed to annex, and the good thing, sorry if this was too quick, the good thing we've done, we didn't allow the other negotiators that came in as allies to grab pieces of Bulgaria for themselves. So yeah, well done. We can now just move our troops. I'll leave them somewhere southern, because for some reason I believe that at some point we are gonna get into war with Greece. Now let's see, we can modify our government again. Chief of Air Force, Chief of Navy, Aircraft Designer, Ship Designer. Activity and research time. Okay. Let's see. Call to arms request from Japan against China. No, not gonna take part of that. We're not gonna take part of your war efforts as well. So we need fighters. We've got three dockyards. We've got three military factories we won. So we actually are going to produce fighters. Total need of one, but we'll soon have more to come. And when it comes to recruit and deployment screen, we should just see. I've never created. Let me just see, how do we create a new air force? Create new air wing. Now I assume this is just tampering with the existing ones. Reorganize this with the air wing into this little. Okay, doesn't matter for the moment. Anyways, we need this one airplane repaired, I'll guess. But we'll see also how to reorganize our air troops at some point, because I want to do it at some point. Okay, let's see. Still building motorized. And yay, 50 equipment needed only. Soviet Union declared war on Finland. Okay, so now we are back to creating infantry equipment that we need. We also created all the motorized we needed. So fighters that we are upgrading now, we'll give them 3. We still have 8 free. And what I'm gonna do is just see, edit. Let's add a medium tank and see how much is it going to cost us to add that, to add engineering company, and to add field hospital to you guys, and to add the same thing to the infantry division. They've got field hospital already. Okay, so let's see, since we are missing medium tanks. Yeah, okay, so we'll start producing medium tanks as well. And let's see, okay, that's nice. We are back to yeah, we are now back to, oh yeah, we can even add to naval dockyards though. I don't know why I'm doing that. I'm just wasting my resources, because I really didn't build any navy, and to start it at 1940 is not gonna take me anywhere. But yeah, we're now rebuilding. We've got 38 days until we build a civilian factory, and after that we're gonna repair the shit we've made and the shit they've made. Okay, fighter 2 artillery, improved artillery. Okay, that's nice, that's nice, that's nice. I'm satisfied with how this shit went. I'm satisfied with how we managed to catch the Bulgarians progress north and cut them off at some point, but that has distracted at least a third of their forces to move away from Sofia and the fights that were happening around it. So yeah, it has given us a nice little chance to you know, take the city and hold it. Yeah, I'm satisfied with how that was done. Maybe our casualties were a bit bigger than we hoped, but we succeeded in grabbing Bulgaria for us. So let's see all the things that we are to build. Support equipment, infantry equipment, motorized, fighter 1. Oh, fighter 1 is gonna be fighter 2 now. Do we have heavy tank 2? No. I'm lost already. Don't know what heavy we studied and what we didn't. Okay, let's just reduce the volume again a bit. Okay, not bad. Not bad. So, Most likely our next target will be Greece. That's the most likely scenario, because at some point I didn't follow it through now while all this shit was happening. But yeah, at some point they'll certainly join the allies. And okay, no need. And they'll join the allies, and you know, that will just be a clear sign to us that they'll be our next enemies. Okay, let's also check if this guy, I think he had skill 3 or something. I think he got some experience. He's at level 84, actually 84% towards the next level. So this is what I was saying. You got a little tab I just thought it was standing here, but actually it's here. Here you can exercise. It's gonna be sending your equipment, but you'll be gaining army experience. But for the moment, we really don't need it. We've got more than enough experience through the battle we've gone through with Bulgaria. Okay. Norway, you're in trouble as well now. White peace. Between the Soviets and the Finland. Nice of you guys. So, I assume we'll have a period of stagnant game now again for some while. Let's see, where can we go further? Yeah, we've got 48 days until we finish with this. Heavy tanks. 229 more. But only 93 days until we have medium tanks too, so yeah, why not? Can quickly research it and further improve on our own tanks. Yeah, now since we are allied with Germans and basically since we are in the Axis, we can see their troops and where they are. Maybe the only mistake was that we didn't call in for allies earlier. Just because they have, the Germans at least, they've got a great number of planes, so they could have helped out by bombing the Bulgarians and disorganizing their troops more. But it will not turn bad this way as well. Okay. Yeah, we are doing good. We're doing good. Most of the needs are filled, except for the infantry equipment that really requires a lot. But you can't have it all. So, yes, you'll have to turn to infantry equipment at some point. But that'll be all for this session. Gotta take some break. We'll continue recording later on. Hope you liked it so far. Subscribe if interested in more Hearts of Iron or similar games. And hope you got to learn the basics of the game through this, but also do not miss the end of the game or the second part, so to say, where we'll be covering a period of 1940 to 1944. I don't know exactly, as I said, when does the game end, but I assume quite a few interesting things gonna happen, and let's see whether Yugoslavia can hold out to the breath and whether Axis can take the win, or are Russians and US troops actually gonna change something. Stay safe, we'll get in touch again.